Good morning. Happy Friday. I don't even know if you can see me. It's pretty dark outside. I just wanted to wish you guys a happy Friday and hope you're doing well. I know it's going to be the weekend and I'm sure many of you have plans. And I just wanted to say that even if you have plans, there's no reason why you can't stay on program or on track and be focused, right? So, you know, sometimes, you know, in our life, we're going to be invited to parties and celebrations and go out for dinners. Have people over to visit. Maybe you can see me now. I'm in front of a school. I'm walking on the main street because it's pretty dark out and I'm gonna go over to where there's some light on the situation, and then maybe you can see me. Can you see me? I can see myself. Good morning. How's everybody? There we go. I'm in front of this high school near my school. Anyways, I just wanted to say that even if you're invited out, you know, if you pre-plan, what I like to do is sometimes I don't starve myself during the day, but I might just eat a little bit less, fill up on some high protein, vegetables, yogurt, fruit, drink lots of water, and save a good amount of points for when I'm going out. I also like to make sure that I bring things with. So if I'm going somewhere like tonight to my brother's, I'm planning to bring some of that Chapman's ice cream, and I'm gonna bake one of my low-fat banana breads. So this way, if I want to have some dessert, I'm in control. I always offer to usually bring a veggie platter. I always have one out when people come to my house, and some low-fat crackers, hummus, things like that. I always keep bars or something in my purse. And even if people say, oh, don't bring anything, I still bring something. So there's always a way around it. Also, maybe get in a little bit more walking or exercise that day. And that's a good thing to do, obviously, because work off some of those calories that you're going to be eating. Or if you have time to go afterwards, before, after, whatever. Okay? So just a few tips for you guys for the weekend coming up. So it's Friday. I'm very excited. I'm going to be, as I mentioned, out tonight. And then tomorrow I'm out with my mom. And then on Sunday, my daughter and I are going to go visit my sister. And we also are planning our lunch. We're going to bring her some nice lunch with. And that's it. That's what's happening in my life. What's happening in your life? Let me know, share what's going on, share your strategies of what you guys do when you're planning parties or going out and celebrating. I'm not saying that you can't indulge. You can certainly indulge, but just modify your indulgence. You know, the other day in my staff room, they brought in treats, and they brought in for Diwali, and I tried a piece of samosa. I just took a piece off, and then there was some other delicious thing that was deep fried with, I thought it was potato, but I found out that it was cauliflower. And I just took a little piece, and sometimes just having a little piece of something rather than nothing, you don't feel deprived. You feel empowered because you only took a little bit, you tried it. And one of my coworkers said to me, how did you do that? How come you just took a little bit? And I said, you know, a little bit goes a long way, you know, for me anyways. Now that's my non-scale victories, to be able to do that. The old Risa wouldn't have been able to do that. Or if I'm out with my daughter, I'll hint, I'll say, Zoe, don't you want that ice cream? Don't you want that muffin? And then I just have a little piece. So, you know, I'm not saying you can't have anything, because when you can't, that's when you want to binge, right? So, you know, find things that you like. I love exploring in the grocery store. That's like one of my favorite pastimes. Never go shopping with me, guys. So, honestly, find things that you can have, keep in your house. I have a stash under my coffee table of my things, my Good Thins, my puffs, my low-fat popcorn. And then my husband has his stash, and my daughter with their junk. So at least when I want to grab for something, I grab for something healthy. Okay, so that's some of my tips for the weekend, for life. Just in general, okay? So, happy weekend. Have a wonderful weekend. Stay on track. I'll go live soon and touch base with you people. I love you. 18,000 people, plus, plus, plus. We're going to get there and help everybody, right? My passion is to help people. And my other passion is for parents to start helping their kids. We've seen so many kids working in a school, so many overweight children. So get them involved, get them to grocery shop, get them to help you cook and bake, make it fun, make it exciting. Get them to exercise with you. Take the dog for a walk, you know, play ball with them, go to the park. I did that with Zoe. Badminton, whatever, swimming. This winter, go ice skating. Tobogganing is great exercise, going up and down those hills. Oh my God. I love that. I do that with my students. So much fun. So you can find things to do. There's no excuses, people. Oh, one thing I want to say is even if you are exercising, you don't have to just do everything all at once, okay? You can do it in intervals, all right? Like, so if you don't have time, people say, I don't have time. You have time, even for 10 minutes, shake your booty, put on some music, go up and down your stairs, walk up and down your hall. You can find the time. And then it doesn't matter if you don't do it all at once. That is my point. So that is another tip, people. All right, I love you guys. Just a few helpful tips. I hope this helps you guys. Mwah. I love you, and keep telling people about my group and my videos, and I'm here for you. You know that. Take care. Bye for now.